For decorating the cover, the first thing we'll be doing is taking out our ribbon and approximately measure 12 inches and just cut 2 pieces of it. So I have 2 pieces of ribbon here. Now you see the right side, the opening here, anywhere in the middle, okay? You don't have to be perfect, guys. Anywhere in the middle, just apply a little bit of glue and take your ribbon and just place this here and allow it to dry for a while, okay? After one side dries, let's move on to the other side. So once you think this side is dry, pretty good, just flip this over and you see where this ribbon hits the album. Apply glue straight right there and take out your other piece and just glue it this way. Okay, so that both are straight. Now allow this to dry. The next thing is, in your paper pack, you will find 2 of these prints, okay? Now double these up, okay? Let's set our album aside for a while. Now double both these sheets and measure over 7 3/4 of an inch and cut. The first cut, let me show you. So here is my trimmer. I'm lining the papers to 7 3/4 of an inch and I'm just slicing it down like this, okay? So this is what you should have, and this is the remaining piece. Now put this piece into your scrap pile, okay? So whenever I need this piece, I will tell you to take this out from your scrap pile, and you have to take the same piece, or if you want to just personalize it on your own, you can do it. But we want to remain consistent of our cuts, so we are doing this. Now you should have this piece, which is 12 inches long by 7 3/4 inch wide. Now just turn this over so that it is 12 inches wide. Now measure over 7 3/4 of an inch and cut. So let me show you once again. Then the remainder of the tutorial, the cuts, you can make it on your own. So the leftover piece, again, you put this into your scrap pile. So whenever I need it, I'll ask you guys, okay? So this is what you should have. Now let's take out our album and place one of these here, and you can see that you will have a good white border on all 4 sides here. So apply glue to the back and glue this down, centering it from side to side, okay, and top to bottom. So after applying glue, just place this center from side to side and top to bottom, okay? You'll have 1/8 inch border all around, okay? And then burnish this down really good and flip the album over and do the same for the back side also. So now this is what your album should look like. Now I am just going to open my album up without damaging the inner pages here and find my paper for the spine piece. In your scrap pile, you will find this piece, which was the cutting from our cover page. This one is 4 1/4 inch by 7 3/4 inch, okay? Now looking at it, so that it is 4 1/4 inches wide, measure over 2 inches and cut. This is what you should have. Now if you place this centered from top to bottom and side to side, your album spine will look something like this, okay? So apply glue and glue this down. So this is what my spine piece looks like. So this is the front, this is the spine piece, and this is your back. So the next thing we are going to do is our shaker element. So for my shaker element, I have made this heart template on my own with my bare hands. You can do circle or square or rectangle, or you can do the heart as well. So this is just my own scribblings and I cut it freehandedly. So now for this shaker part, I am choosing this print, which is in the paper pack. Now I'll just flip this over and trace this heart on the top corner of the paper here and cut this out. So I have traced this all along. Now before cutting this, first of all, I will be measuring over 4 1/2 inches and cutting, okay? You guys measure how much you want and you guys cut, but maximum you just have 4 1/2 inches, so that let's remain consistent on our cuttings. So now this is 12 inches long. Now measure over 7 1/2 inches and cut. Now I will be cutting out the hearts. You guys, if you want a rectangle frame, you can have a 1/2 inch frame all around here. So get ready for the shaker part now. So this is what my heart looks like. My heart is not perfect, guys, but still once you complete your layouts, your layout is going to look so beautiful that people might not be able to recognize that you've made some mistakes. So I am going to place my hearts like this, okay? So before placing that, I am going to take out my acetate sheet and glue this down to the back side. So I have a small strip of acetate here. Now I am going to place this here and glue this down and then cut out and around this piece, okay? So this is what mine looks like after I glued my acetate sheet. Now let me flip this over and take out my foam tape, okay? And place this all over the sides of the hearts. So as you can see, I have lined my double-sided tape. Now let me take out my album and just fairly make a placement and start taking my sequins out. Now I'm also adding this glitter here to the sequins part here. Before that, let me just open the album up so that I'll be flat while gluing this down. Now I have spread the sequins and glitter out. Now I'm going to remove the backing of this and I'm going to place it right like this. I have removed the backing now. Now let's place this like this and burnish this down really good with your bone folder. Now let's do the shaker part. Wow, so cute. I really love the layout. Now let's start decorating our cover. So now I am done decorating mine. I have placed few of the Little Buddy Craft flowers here and some of the craft tales tag sheets elements here, and here it says our love story begins here. Now this is dimensional. I have placed a double-sided tape here, and as you can see, it's so beautiful and the shaker element is just cute, so cute. Now let's see for the spine piece here. So for the spine piece, I have glued this cute little teddy with a balloon and some Little Buddy Craft flowers. So this is what the front looks like, and the shaker element is here. And so we are done decorating the cover, guys. Now let's move on to the inside, that is page one. So for our inner pages, in your paper pack, you will find these two prints, which are the same. Now the first cut, which we are going to do is, first let us double them up and then turn this so that your love and all is going this way, okay? Now measure over 7 inches and cut. So this is what you should have. Turn this so that it is 12 inches across, looking at it the right way. Measure over 7 1/4 inches and cut, okay? 7 1/4 inches and cut, like this. So put the other pieces in your scrap pile. So this is what you should have. This is your base page. Now, let me just show you what I mean. So this is our pages. So we will be reading our album like reading a book. So this is page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4, page 5, page 6, and page 7, page 8. So we have total 8 pages. So when you place this like this, you will have 1/8 inch border all around, okay? This is your trim here. Let me place something back behind so that you can see the edges really good. So this is the edge here. When you place this like this, so that your love is going this way, you will see that you will have 1/8 inch border all around, okay? So this is how our base page is going to be placed. So set these two aside in a separate pile because we will be grabbing this whenever we need this. In your paper pack, you will find this print. Now turn this so that your arrow marks are going this way. Measure over 7 inch and cut. Then this is what you should have. Keep them both doubled up, guys. And measure over 7 1/4 inches and cut. So this is what you should have, guys. 2 7 1/4 inch by 7 inches. Now set this with these two pages, okay? Set this aside with these both. Now in your paper pack, you will find this print here, okay? The blueprint, okay? Two of those. Now measure over 7 inch and cut. Keep them doubled up, guys, like this, and measure over 7 1/4 inch and cut, okay? Now this is what you should have. Set this aside with the other four base pages. Now in your paper pack, you should find this heart prints. Now looking at it the right way, okay? So that your hearts are straight, measure over 7 inch and cut. Now keep them doubled up. Now looking at it so that it is 12 inches across, measure over 7 1/4 inches and cut. So this is what you should have. Now set all these 8 base pages aside. Now let's get into our page 1.